So how do you interpret cholesterol tests, a lipid panel? Lipid just means fats, oils, and usually when your doctor says he's going to order a lipid panel, he's talking about cholesterol tests. There are other fats in there besides cholesterol. There's the LDL, which is bad cholesterol, and HDL, which is good cholesterol, total cholesterol, and then the other lipid in there is usually triglycerides. But we'll talk about that in just a minute. Let me just tell you how we're going to do this. I'm going to use my own study. We just had the Healthy Life Summit Part 2, the second event in Orlando, March of 2019. It's probably going to be a month or two before you see the video because we've got so many in the queue. But it was a great event. We had a lot of YouTubers there. The YouTubers distinguished themselves. They knew their stuff. It's a very good group of people. In fact, what they did was convince us that we'll be starting a series of events on our own, probably Louisville near us, which has some good access in terms of airports. But that's for another time. One thing I do want to say is that we did get reminded many times that YouTube's just not sending out notices. And I looked it up. It's less than 20%. Even if you click subscribe and you click the bell, less than 20% your probability you're going to get all of the videos. So what I would ask is you go to our the description underneath, click on Join the Community, and actually join the community. Basically, give us your email address. We'll send you information so you can get all the videos you want. We're also developing a library. So another piece of feedback they gave us is that it's hard to find. There's 500 videos, and we haven't tried to organize them that well. You could try the playlists, but they're not that well organized either, and there's junk in there. So again, please join us, give us your email list, and we'll start helping you find the information that you need. So I've done another video using my own labs from the Healthy Life Summit. That was on inflammation panel. Again, you can Google that, look it up, or give us your email list, and we should have that in part of our new library functions that we're sending out. Remember, the most important one was microalbumin creatinine ratio. Microalbumin is what the protein you're spilling in the urine. So there's most of the lab tests that we got from the old CHL Quest derivative now started off with microalbumin. But even if you know to look for microalbumin, there's about three or four and then five, and then you're trying to figure out, well, which of these do I look at? It's this one, microalbumin creatinine ratio, random urine, and again, that shows us the protein we're spilling. Not going to get any deeper into that. That's on another video. We'll probably look at what's called the metabolic panel. You usually don't see that much on it, but again, it's always there. It's cheap for the lab to do, and sometimes you pick up stuff on that. In addition, the OGTT is a big deal, as you see. I've done a lot of work in terms of working out, resistance training, sauna, which may or may not work, low carbs, and high-intensity intervals. And as you see, my number's a little bit better, especially in terms of the fasting number of 86. But after a shot of 75 grams of fructose, my number goes right up to 183. And 200 is one of the definitions for full-blown diabetes. So I've got it. I've got a good lifestyle. What's causing it? Aging. I'm 62 years old. And after another hour, it only gets down to 114. Perfect numbers would be starting out at 80 in the 80s, like I did. Not getting any higher than 120 after that 75 gram fructose or glucose challenge. And then getting down significantly below 100 after the second hour. That's not where I was. This next section has to do with thyroid, which is a very common problem as we age. And it also has to do with the blood panel. Again, other information for another time period. So we were talking about lipid panels. Quest and CHL, their CHL, the old Cleveland Heart Lab division of Quest, now puts this out, and for the most part tends to label it as cardio IQ, and they give you a little bit more than the standard lipid panel. I can tell you, and I continue to tell all my patients, I don't need anything other than the standard lipid panel. However, that's not what they give you anymore. They've done it so many times, they start giving you lipoprotein fractionation, apolipoproteins, and stuff like that. And sure enough, we'll go through that just to provide some more information. The top number is the total cholesterol. The most important number that I look at is actually a ratio of two numbers. It's the next two numbers. It's triglycerides over HDL. If you're in the one area, you're doing great. You're in good shape. You're not burning a lot. You don't have a constant insulin push going on. If, on the other hand, you're insulin resistant and or you're eating a lot of carbs on a regular basis, which can happen even with young people with obesity or diabetes problems that aren't recognized or treated. Insulin does two things. It pulls sugar out of the blood and puts it into the muscle or liver cell where it's not dangerous. And number two, here's where this comes in. It stops burning fats. It stops triglyceride burnings. Triglycerides are the fats that you have. I've got some down here on some, they're small love handles, but I got some love handles, and that's where that fat is. I've got it elsewhere too. But insulin will stop your body from burning that. So what will happen is your triglycerides will begin to elevate. Meanwhile, as those begin to elevate, you start burning your HDL cholesterol more. So HDL cholesterol drops down into the 40s, sometimes lower. Triglycerides go up 100, 150. And so what happens is you get a ratio of 100 over 50 or 45. That shows that you've got insulin resistance. That's, in fact, the first thing that I look at on the lipid panel. As you see from my numbers, I'm in good shape. And it's because of the lifestyle that I'm leading, not eating carbs and doing plenty of exercise. So just as a summary, and in case you didn't pick up on it, the first thing I look at in terms of the cholesterol or lipid panel is not really cholesterol or lipid. It's back to insulin resistance. So LDL cholesterol is usually calculated. There's several different methods that they have for calculating it. Most common and simplest calculation has to do with a little bit more complicated version than taking the total cholesterol and subtracting the HDL. As you see, if you did that simply here, you'd get a pretty good estimate of my LDL. They are looking on ways to actually measure it, and some labs are getting there. Bottom line is my LDL is 107. Am I worried about that? No. What's the standard? Well, they say the standard is less than 100, but that's typical labs and lab standards. We really want it less than 70. So should I crank up, as I've shared with you many times, I did bite the bullet 3 or 4 years ago and start taking Crestor. Should I bite the bullet and increase that Crestor? Increase it from what? I started at 5 milligrams a day, and I went to every other day. And then at this point, I'm down to 2.5 milligrams of rosuvastatin or Crestor twice a week. I might, because when you go back up, you may remember I've got a tiny bit of inflammation going on as well. So I've got a little bit of an increase in my LDL. I've got some mild inflammation. You can always do more in terms of lifestyle. I'm working on that. I may go back up and increase to 5 milligrams 2 or 3 times a week on my Crestor. So again, those of you that are statin haters, we're not talking about very much. The other thing I'm considering doing, but we got an influx of patients, and Michelle's very busy. She and I are considering setting me up on Livalo. Livalo is now getting to where it's available through some Canadian pharmacies, pitavastatin generic, and it's a much more manageable price than it's been in the past. What's the interest in Livalo? Well, it was developed in Japan. It's the only statin, and it's now getting affordable. It's the only statin which decreases insulin resistance. All the other ones, including Crestor, have a negative impact on insulin resistance. So what we've done in the past is try to manage inflammation with Crestor, use small amounts of it so you don't get that push on insulin resistance, but it certainly doesn't help. So those are a couple of things that I'm thinking about, increasing my Crestor dose just a little bit, and or when Michelle gets beyond this flurry of activity for Healthy Life Summit 2 in Orlando, she and I'll get me set up and where she can help our patients, including me, get the Livalo. Cholesterol over HDLC ratio, that's not that helpful. If you look at the things that we've looked at already, you're going to get 90% of what you need out of your cholesterol tests. But you know what? They do these other tests, they get these numbers, and because they do, patients perseverate over it. They focus on it. They worry about it. So let me just tell you a little bit about that. The LDL particle number for me is a little bit high, and we've got small LDLs. Those two things go hand in hand. You're going to have the same amount of LDL if you've got the big fluffy. Here's what the issue is. The big fluffy LDLs don't go through that injured intima layer, the holes in it. They're too big. It's the small, dense LDLs that go through. So you want to get more of the large LDLs, in other words, medium here, and less of the small. And many people and many labs will call that a pattern B that I have. In other words, more of the small, dense LDL. The other thing is you want these larger HDL particles, which is, again, what I've got there. So I've got a little bit too much LDL, and it's too many small particles. Again, the pattern that many labs will call pattern B. Apolipoprotein A1, that's the protein itself that forms a ball, wraps around cholesterol such that you don't get big blobs or an embolus of liquids. Lipids, the fats. As you remember, when you hold you pour oil in a glass of water and you shake it a little bit, it forms a large blob. That large blob could cause heart attack, stroke, or other injury. And in fact, it does in medicine when you have large bones break. That's what lipoproteins are all about. The apolipoprotein is the protein part without the lipids in it. So you're looking to see which protein is in there. Apolipoprotein A1 is the good one in the HDL particle. Apolipoprotein B is the one in the LDL particles. So what you can see, you want to have more of the apolipoprotein A and less of apolipoprotein B. And that's my LP little a. So it's a little bit higher than I'd want, but I don't worry about my LP little a. So you may be looking, you may have a question. Well, Ford, I look down there and you've got an MPO of 542. As I said, that's the most common false positive. I usually don't worry about that unless I see a major pattern with multiple significantly positive inflammation markers. As usual, I went longer than I expected, But as you can tell, I'm passionate about this. And if you've made it this far, thank you so much for your interest. Thanks. And if you hit that subscribe or like button, it makes a big difference. An even bigger difference happens when you share. You can share on Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter, Pinterest. When you do that, it makes a big difference in terms of the algorithm. It sends this to other people, realizing that humans think this is interesting information and helpful. Thank you again. We're planning a PrevMed only event on November 8th and 9th in Louisville at the University of Louisville Conference Center. Michelle posted this preliminary statement on Thursday or Friday, and within an hour, we had one person already purchase a slot and two other people wanted to reserve slots. Why did we do this and what are we talking about? Well, the Healthy Life Summit was about three-quarters of the folks were YouTube viewers of this channel. And they gave us really good feedback. They said it was a great event, but we really need to focus more on just PrevMed type of stuff, looking at specifically heart attack, stroke prevention, dementia prevention, have topics related only to what we're doing, cardiovascular inflammation, major causes like insulin resistance, lifestyle interventions, stroke prevention, those types of things, and not do any of the other business related items. So that's what we're going to do. And like the Healthy Life Summit, we have a couple of options. One is to just come in. You will get the CIMT if you just come to the event. The other one is to get a complete evaluation. So it would be 2 days with CIMT and labs. So it's a great way to do it. That was the other thing that the YouTube viewers told us. They said it's a great way. You come in, you get a complete evaluation. You get your CIMT, which is very difficult to find, and you get your all your labs. And you have a two-day boot camp on what all of this means. So, yes, we have it getting started, and it's coming out of the blocks pretty popular. So go on over to the website, take a look, and tell us what you think. I'm going to be, I recently recorded another video which used this same slide deck and got into a lot more detail regarding how the costs are developed. It's expensive whenever you start doing all of this testing. We'll get into some of those details later, but this is just an announcement, and look forward to seeing you there if you can come. Thanks.